Mayans discovered at breeding facility are so sick they don't even have fur. In South Africa, more lions live in farms than out in the wild. Here's what's really happening in those so-called farms, which are actually breeding facilities. Undercover photographs taken on the Panika farm, located in the Northwest Province, reveal how terrible conditions are for the animals. Lions sit on dusty, barren, and dry ground, surviving on scraps of meat, covered in mange and nearly entirely hairless. The harrowing pictures show lions in crowded locations without access to water and shelter. Others show lion cubs who can barely even stand due to disease. This is sadly not the only farm of its kind. Approximately 200 so-called farms are part of this huge network designed to provide for the large cat industry. They are what the Humane Society International calls snuggle scams, as they trick people from around the world and tourists into supporting them by pretending to be something they're not, a loving lion farm where the cats thrive and play. HSI Africa's wildlife director, Audrey Delsink, states that the captive lion breeding market in South Africa involves nothing but exploitation from the moment those lions are born till their last second alive, and that it's a vicious cycle. Cubs are taken from their mother at a mere couple days of age. Volunteers from the United Kingdom are tricked into believing they're orphan cubs and therefore help to hand raise them. Then the lions grow big and become dangerous and they're slaughtered. Their bones are sent to different Asian countries where they're used for traditional medicinal purposes. Others are simply sold to mainly American trophy hunters who use them for canned hunts and kill them for sport within an enclosed location. Today, less than 3,000 lions live in the South African wilds. These breeding farms have over twice that amount of lions. In Panika Farm, there are more than 100 of them. And now that the facility is facing legal challenges, the adult lions' futures hang in the balance. Luckily, the sick cubs have been taken to a veterinarian and will likely receive the care they need. But for the other lions, their lives are at stake. This is because they were hand-raised and bred in captivity, so they don't have the skills needed to survive.